Our India News are organizations shrinking into a screen with hybrid work models. With the hybrid model as the future of workplaces, people would continue to work from home on some days of the week. In the last 15 months, we have seen organizations across the world see themselves shrink into a screen. Virtual existence and work from home became a way of life as workers embraced the new normal despite several glitches. The future of a hybrid model workplace depends on how companies can also create a more connected, distributed workplace. The world has shifted towards a more distributed workforce, and with recent global events, hybrid work is here to stay. Users now expect to connect from anywhere and on any device, while security teams have the same complex, but piecemeal and time-consuming solutions. It is time to rethink security. The idea is to focus on basic safety protocols, cleanliness, routine sanitization, and adjusting space density to maintain distance. With agility, innovation, and quick response to customer needs being the strengths, the flexible workspace is an achievable concept for the organizations. On these lines, employees of bigger corporations are now expecting the adoption of similar restructuring. Change is always constant and it is inevitable. However, this pandemic has made us realize that we are capable of change, enabling remote workforces, adapting to changes, customer behaviors, or even reviewing and changing entire business models. We have seen it all in the last year. Technology is the common denominator here, and it is now more influenced than ever. The digital economy, triggered by the pandemic, promises to bring in an unprecedented confluence of people, businesses, and things that can reconstruct existing business models. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Chuck Robbins addressing the virtual RSA conference. Cisco unveiled innovations to further its journey to radically simplify and deliver end-to-end security across users, devices, networks, applications, and data. Announcements today improve extended detection and response, that is XDR, with greater visibility across network, endpoint, and cloud. New innovations expand Cisco's vision for Secure Access Service Edge, that is SASE, which enhanced threat detection in the cloud and redefined and simplified network security. India most hit by ransomware attacks in 2021, says Checkpoint Research. Ransomware attack could be the internet's next big threat. A new report by Checkpoint Research suggests that ransomware attacks around the globe have gone up by 102% in 2001 compared to 2020. Further, the report states that India is the most impacted country with 213 weekly ransomware attacks per organization, which is 17% up from the beginning of the year. At this point, attackers usually demand a ransom in exchange of getting access to your files again. PUBG Mobile game is back in India with its new battlegrounds. PUBG Mobile has made a comeback as an Indian exclusive version called Battlegrounds Mobile India. After teasing these releases for several months, the developers Craftron Inc. have officially launched the game. Battlegrounds Mobile India is expected to offer the gaming modes that PUBG Mobile used to offer. It will include Battle Royale, Team Deathmatch, War Mode, and more. Fosun Pharma-backed BioNTech hires Jens Holstein as CFO. Jens Holstein will oversee a massive inflow of cash that will potentially fuel the ambitions of BioNTech's co-founder and chief executive Uğur Şahin to develop precision immunotherapies against various forms of cancer and other diseases. Previously, Holstein served in various finance and management positions at diversified healthcare group Fresenius SE. Facebook expands COVID-19 announcement tool to India. Today, Facebook announced it is expanding on the COVID-19 announcement in India, which is a tool for the health departments of states and union territories to share essential COVID-19 related updates with their communities. This is part of our ongoing efforts to support the public health authorities' work to keep people safe and informed during the coronavirus public health crisis. India is the second country after the US to launch this feature, and we have partnered with 33 states and union territories to roll this out in their respective jurisdictions. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.